water and earth, cold and humid, lubrication of body and shape of body. This is kapha. Natural moisture of our body, natural moisture in our skin, natural moisture in our mouth, eyes, nose, ears, between joints, between muscles. Kapha helping the body to move smoothly. If you have less kapha, you will listen click click sometime joints. Means the lubrication is less, dryness is coming. This is kapha. Kapha is getting less, vata is increasing. And the structure of the body, shape of the body due to earth element. If you say I have no kapha, you will have no physical body. Subtle body can be, but physical body will be not. We are sitting due to kapha. We are walking due to vata. We need walking also, we need sitting also. When you have a posture, when you have a structure, you can have a shape. This is due to kapha. Vata and kapha, two opposite energies. Yeah? Only one property common, cold property. Vata is dry cold, kapha is humid cold. So nowadays the weather is hot and humid. When you go out, you feel hot and you feel sweaty. So now when you are using this fan, you are using vata energy. You start giving movement and you sit under the fan, you will feel cold and your sweat will dry. So use this. Whenever you are using a fan, whenever you are using air conditioner, you are using vata energy to compensate with pitta, hot and humid. Now you say, I don't want to sit under the fan. I don't want to sit under the AC. I want to take a cold shower. I want to go for swimming. So cold and humid. You can use cold and dry, you can use cold and humid to balance the pitta. So vata, kapha opposite, but we need both. If we have no kapha, we have no physical body. We will not burn. Whenever there is a structure, this is kapha. And shape will come with the earth. When we talk about the space, air, fire, water, they have no structure. When earth comes, then they bind together, then the physical body comes. So if somebody born, something solid came, this is kapha. You start breathing, this is vata. You start eating, flushing out, pitta. So we need all the three. Now, kapha takes little more time to stop working in a dead body. So after some time, if you keep the dead body for a few more hours, after the body become rigid, like a stick, like this. Yeah? Rigor mortis. Rigor mortis, when water element disappear, dry up. So when nowadays very popular people donate organs of a dead body, eyes, heart, liver, kidney, you can donate, till then the kapha energy is working, there is water. So once the water get dry, the body will become dry, and it will become like a stick. That's why if somebody die, we immediately make the body straight. If somebody die in the sitting posture and after a few hours you can't make it like lying position, yeah? The body become rigid. So when the rigidity comes, kapha stop working in the body. So rigor mortis is a kapha. So vata stop right that moment, person stop breathing, vata stop. After a few hours, pitta. After a few hours, more hours, kapha stop working. In living body, it will have vata, pitta, kapha, all. How much? This is the difference. But when we are in the mother's womb, they are working passively. When we take birth, they are start working actively. But everybody has all the three. When these three are in the balance stage, we are healthy, we are balanced. Whenever they are going up and down, we will have problems. And the most important thing, everybody's balance is different. Ayurveda says every individual is individual. No comparison between the two peoples. Even we are twins, we have differences and we have to respect the differences. I can't say this, I have, why not you? You are you, I am I. Everybody is different. And even in your life, you spend quite a long life. Everybody will be more than 20 years of age. You haven't saw two people 100% same. And this is the beauty of Ayurveda also. Same disease, the medicine can be different. because prakriti change, body type change, medicine change.